secret where we are, San Francisco. It's actually our only stop on the West Coast, so we are expecting to see some great things. Hang on tight. This is American Idol. American Idol has a love affair with San Diego. After all, we've come to the city by the bay for three seasons in a row. And why not? This is the home turf of LaToya London. And last season, we found Nadia Turner here. And oh yes, this is the place where we found American Idol legend.
She bangs.
Oh, well, you know who.
Machine moves.
But five, and the stakes are even higher. As the thousands piled into the Cal Palace, it was time to usher in the judges. Thankfully, Randy had confidence.
San Francisco, third time. Hopefully the third time's a charm, y'all.
So the stage was set. Best to start San Francisco off, then a Hawaiian?
My name is Heidi Fairbanks, and people like to call me Happy Heidi from Hawaii. And I'm 22 years old, and I live on the north shore of Oahu, Hawaii. A lot of people tell me I look like Jessica Simpson. My last fortune cookie said, your smile makes other people happy, so I think I'm the girl they're looking for.
What are you gonna sing?
I will be singing, this is my favorite song I sing, and it's by Verdi.
Totally appreciate that. It's beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Do you have another song you want to sing that shows us some versatility in pop?
Down the waterfall, wherever it may take me, I know that love won't break me. When I come to call, he won't forsake me. I'm loving angels instead.
Thank you very much. Simon?
Loved the first song, absolutely hated the second song.
All right.
I think the problem is that you sing that classical style beautifully, and then when I heard the second song, I've heard all that a million times in this competition, which is somebody who just doesn't sound that good. So you're good in one style and not so good in the other style, but the first style won't work within this competition. It's sort of good news and bad news.
I felt like on the Jessica Simpson song, you were just yelling.
Yeah, I think the problem is just on the pop stuff. I mean, I like you. I think the classical song, you were brilliant. Like, wow.
Simon, yes or no?
I have to say no.
I'm going to say yes.
So it's up to me, huh?
Mm-hmm.
God.
Come on, Randy, yes or no?
I'm just so on the fence. Beautiful girl, great opera song, but the pop song was not good. I gotta say no. Mm.
Sorry, Heidi.
Yeah.
Thank you.
So sorry, sweetheart.
Sorry.
I love your voice.
Thank you.
Keep the opera going.
No.
It's okay.
Randy was the deciding vote. He said to pursue opera.
So, Happy Heidi heads back to Hawaii. But waiting in the wings is someone who hopes his opera training will be just what the judges are looking for.
What's going down, baby?
Just the best of me.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
You ready to do this?
I'm ready. My name is Sean Vasquez. I'm from Oakland, California. And I sing like an angel. I've been singing since I was about 2 years old. Now I'm in the process of starting opera lessons to further my education in music. I take my music very serious. I'm destined for something big. I know, I can feel in my heart I'm gonna be something huge one day.
You're not gonna fail in that room, are you?
I hope not. I'm just praying and just trying to keep myself up, and I think I can do it. Matter of fact, I know I can do it.
There you go.
Hey, what's up, y'all? Yeah.
Hey.
What's going down?
Hello, what's your name?
My name is Sean Vasquez.
What do you do, Sean?
I sing. I don't sing, I sang.
You sang.
Okay, and what are you going to sing?
I want to sing Neither One of Us by Gladys Knight and the Pips.
Okay.
When it comes to saying goodbye, there's just a simple word that I just cannot say.
Okay, all right, please.
Thank you very much for that.
That's going to be the loudest ever.
Paula.
There's a spot.
No.
Randy.
Dude, that was the loudest, weirdest sound. It's just, it was just weird, man.
Can I give you one more song? Just like my pitch,
no,
please.
No, I mean, this is my
dream.
What's
song.
Your name?
Simon, this is my dream.
What's your name?
My name is Sean Vasquez.
Let me put this into perspective. You have one of the worst voices I have ever heard. That is how far removed you are from this competition. It is almost non-human.
Oh, that's not, it's not non-human. Sean, singing is not your thing, man. What else do you want to do in your life, dog?
I want to sing.
Well, that's you just, can't.
That's my dream.
No, you really, really can't.
Sorry, man.
Thank you.
Sorry, Sean.
Hang on. Randy, yes or no?
Oh, stop it, Simon.
It was a no.
Why you gotta be so mean?
Not exactly the way we wanted to start things off here in San Francisco, but it is early in the day. Things can definitely turn around. Stay with us. We'll be right back on American Idol.
And when we come back, will anyone be going to Hollywood? Or will a San Francisco showdown threaten to finish the auditions?
You know what you can do on your own for a while.
San Francisco, let's just get through it.
It is mid-morning in San Francisco, and so far, no one's off to Hollywood.
I'm not making it.
It is a no.
But despite the shaky start, the contestants still hold out hope. To pass the time, some try ironing out their vocals. While others simply brace themselves for Simon. But for some, it's all about trying to focus.
Looks like you're ready to be here, dog.
Yes, I am. Yes, I am.
What's your name?
My name is Jose. People call me Sway.
People call you Sway, that's why you got Sway on your buckle.
Yeah, just in case you guys forget my name, it's on my buckle.
Yeah, you're here because you can really do it.
Want me to do it right now?
Go.
Don't remember you told me you love me, baby. You said you'd be coming back this way again, baby. Baby, 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 baby. Oh, baby, I love you. I really do.
Paula, what do you think?
Excellent voice.
Thank you. Thank you.
Kyle?
Very good. Very soulful.
Thank you.
Yeah, I liked it too, man. Paula Abdul, yes or no?
Yes.
Simon Cowell, yes or no?
Yes for me.
Thank you.
So yes for me. Welcome to Hollywood, baby!
So Sway, the first one from San Francisco off to Hollywood, and he seemed to start a lucky streak.
When it's my turn to march up to glory, I'm gonna have one hell of a story.
Yes.
You're going
definitely.
To Hollywood. Congratulations.
Welcome to Hollywood.
And as the golden tickets began to fly out the door.
Absolutely, yes.
Welcome to Hollywood.
It appeared nothing could go wrong.
Hollywood, here I come.
Wow, San Francisco's starting to look up today, man.
But all good things must come to an end.
My name is Matthew Paulson. I'm 21 from Elk Grove, California. I sound a little bit like Clay, but maybe a little bit different than Clay, but I think my voice range is around Clay Aikens. I'm definitely going to Hollywood today.
Hey, what's going on, man?
Hopefully I'm gonna make it to Hollywood, that's what.
Your nickname's Wolfie?
Yes.
And why is that?
Because I love wolves and all my friends know me as Wolfie because I love wolves.
Wow, what are you gonna sing today?
The Measure of a Man by Clay Aiken.
Wow, okay.
Wow, wow.
If one day you discover him, broken down, he's lost everything. No cars, no fancy clothes to make him who he's not. The woman at his side is all that he has got. Why do you ask him, move heaven and earth, to prove his love has worth? Would he walk on water? Would he... Oops, sorry.
It's okay. It's all right.
Sorry about that.
What do you think Clay would have thought of that performance, dude?
I would hope he liked it. And I hope you guys liked it, too.
Dude, it was really terrible.
One of the worst we've ever heard.
It really was.
It was. I mean, it wasn't a great singing audition, but...
Randy.
No.
Hideous.
Okay. Thank you.
I like wolves, too, though.
You're mean.
Dude, I'm saying, I was like, wow.
So no. I think the judges did make a mistake and they didn't understand my similarities to Clay again.
Well, maybe they didn't see the similarity, but let's look back and let you decide.
The woman at his side is all he has got. Why do you ask him, move heaven and earth?
Whatever, dude. Next.
So is Wolfie as good as Clay? Remember how it works. You vote, you decide. We'll be right back on Idol.
Coming up, the king of pop. The queen of rock.
Say it, baby.
And a battle royale.
Welcome back to Idol by the Bay. Now, let's say that you're overseas serving in the Air Force, but your dream... So, what's the first thing you do when you get discharged? You audition for American Idol.
I don't know. A little nervous.
Get in the zone. You'll be all right.
My name is... I'm from Sacramento, California. Been in the military for 9 years. Deployed overseas to desert, so I just got... Started about, about 6 weeks ago.
Mm-hmm. Looking now... Into the nighttime, the city to sleep by. Hey, why? Tell him that it's human nature. Why does he do me that way? And they say, why?
Hold up. Remix. Boom, boom, ah. Boom, boom, ah. Boom, boom. Thank you.
Wow. We've never seen an audition like that.
No, we haven't.
We've never seen that.
Randy?
I like the remix part. So, dude, do you do this act? Because I'd like to refer to it as an act. And go here in town or like it?
Actually, no, sir.
I'm just all a bit, like Randy is a little bit puzzled that someone from the Air Force does quite a strange routine, and after that bizarre element, you stood there with a very serious look on your face, as if that's just normal.
Yeah.
It was a little bit over the top.
Is that a yes or no?
I'm going to say no.
Say yes.
So it's left up to me. The voice is okay. It's just all the other stuff is just so wild that I feel like it belongs in like some circus with it. I don't, it's weird.
You may say maybe so whatever like that, but it will fill those
yeah,
seats.
Yeah, I thought that was a bit rude.
Oh,
right, Simon.
What's rude?
The circus thing. I think that was unnecessary, Randy.
Oh, yeah, oh.
Wow. Bit harsh.
Simon, saying things are harsh.
Yes or no, Randy?
This San Francisco day is strange, dude. It's a wild place. Welcome to Hollywood, dog.
Whoa,
you got a second chance, man.
Can
he is nuts.
Your vocal teacher, she knew all along.
So John's off to Hollywood with a little help from his voice teacher, but he wasn't auditioning her to bring along a vocal coach.
You got it. I told you from the beginning, from the minute I saw you,
all right,
you had the it factor.
All right. She says so.
Teacher. So fa, so mi, so re, so do. I wanna be teacher's
pet. That's
one. I wanna be Hollywood's
first. This your vocal?
Yeah, there you go.
You're selling her.
My vocal coach taught me to breathe deeply.
And in San Francisco, we met the mother of all vocal coaches, Catherine McPhee's mom.
She can sing.
Can she?
Sure.
Oh, boy. Well, you're an expert.
My mom was teaching voice lessons, like, since I was in her belly.
As a little girl, she would vocalize all the time. So then I started training her.
So four counts, then come down.
She's a voice teacher, so she always has a note for me.
Now that's hurting your voice right there, what you just did. Okay. So really shape those vowels, because, you know, I used to dream. You've got to get the right note.
How is she? Scale 1 to 10.
20.
A 20? All right, now just give the mom. How good is she? Scale 1 to 10.
10.
She was much better the other way, wasn't she?
Hi, sweetheart.
Catherine,
how old are you?
I'm 21.
You're excited, aren't you?
I'm very excited.
Okay, Catherine, what's your story?
My mom's a voice teacher and a singer, so kind of got like the stage mother thing going, and
I bet she's standing outside right now.
Oh, yeah.
So, possibly living her career through you.
A little bit, I think so.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. And what are you going to sing?
I'm going to sing God Bless a Child.
Okay.
Them that's God shall get, them that's not shall lose. So the Bible said, and it still is news. A mama may have, papa may have, but God bless a child that's got his own. That's got his own. My name, you got lots of friends crowding round your door. Oh, when you're gone and spending ends, they don't come no more.
Okay. Parts of that was absolutely fantastic.
Thank you.
Randy?
Best voice I've heard so far this auditioning season. Absolutely brilliant. You are really good.
Thank you.
You're absolutely beautiful, too. How old are you?
21.
You should be excited. Your mom's going to be proud.
I know, awesome. I thought they would cry.
I'll tell you what I love about you. You're very current.
Yeah.
You know, you're very, very current. You're,
current?
You know, current. In other words,
good.
You're on the money, you know?
Good.
It's not stage school, it's not wannabe-ish, it's just very, very, very what is happening today.
And what a natural gift. God, whoa.
Amazing. Randy, yes or no?
100% you are what this competition's about. This is 100% yes.
Paula?
I've got goosebumps. Yes.
You are sailing through to Hollywood, young lady.
Welcome to Hollywood, Catherine Neal!
I hear some screaming in the room. You ready? If we find one superstar in one city, that's all it takes, one winner. It's American Idol. We'll be right back.
Coming up, she's a poet, but what happens when she opens her mouth to sing?
Cut that.
A small town girl hits the big city. And Simon throws a fit.
Welcome back.
back to American Idol here in San Francisco. Now, some would say, whew, what a risk to show up in the same place where we found William Hung. But we have hope. There's undiscovered talent here, right?
Should I place them by your gates? Ooh, sad-eyed lady, should I wait?
But local poet Shalisha Carlisle is confident she'll be sparking a different reaction from the judges.
Let your next move be your best move, because I am the next American Idol.
My name is Shalisha Carlisle. I recently discovered a talent that I did not know I had. I can actually sing. I can hold a note. I quit my job to come on American Idol. My voice is very different than anyone else's voice. It's the best voice in the world. It's the voice of the next American Idol.
I quickly give my freedom to be held in your cap. Captivity. Tell me what is love to prove I am ready for love.
Cries from the ghetto. I hear that baby crying. I see a grown man dying. Someone's mother is shooting herself in the arm with a needle, and you probably think I'm lying because you've never been subjected to the excruciating cries of the ghetto.
Okay, do you do anything a little bit more cheerful?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
I like the shoes off, though.
Thank you.
And the choreography is hideous.
Thank you.
Well, it wasn't a compliment.
Don't you wish your girlfriend was hot like me? Don't you wish your girlfriend was a freak like me?
Yeah, yeah.
Don't you? Hey.
Hey.
Don't you? I got some Mary J. Blige. I'm so sorry, sorry, sorry. Sorry. See, what did I do wrong? I say,
okay, there's an answer to that. We're going to stop this.
That was a whole medley. You did a show.
I wanted more.
No, I didn't.
I quit my job.
It wasn't the best career move in the world, this, I don't think.
But I'm very excited.
We're not.
This is my life.
Yes.
I'm going to have to say 100% no.
Okay.
Randy?
Baby, you ain't got it going on. You ain't ready for this at all, dude. No, no, no. No, no, no.
I'm gonna have to pass. Sorry.
That's three no's, sweetheart. And I am willing, because I like you, to phone up your boss and get your old job back. And I'm happy to do that.
Okay.
Okay.
Jenny? Hi, my name is Simon Cowell. I work on a show called American Idol. I've got one of your ex-employees here, Shalicia.
Oh, my God!
Yeah, well, hi, Jenny!
That was my reaction. And I feel a bit guilty because she left her job to audition for us.
She's had three no's.
She was absolutely appalling, but in my opinion, one of the best salespeople I've ever met. So I'm asking you personally if she can have her job back.
Absolutely.
Yes. Ah, thank you.
So it's a yes.
It's a yes.
It's a yes. You're a very nice boss. I'll put you back. Bye, sweetheart.
Bye, Simon.
See you later.
You the folks.
And for some folks, auditioning for American Idol is not only a chance to expose their talents, but it's also an excuse to flee their small towns and hit the big city. Shauna White and her family did just that.
Willits, California is about 3 hours north of San Francisco, and it's a very tight-knit community. Everybody sort of knows everybody. Singing's always sort of been a part of my life. When I was growing up, my dad was in a rock band.
You've taught her everything she knows.
No, she's teaching me some things now.
Welcome to American Idol. What's your name?
Shauna White.
How old are you?
16.
Great.
I could stay home every night, wait around for Mr. Right, take cold showers every day and throw my life away.
Okay.
Thank you very much. Paula.
I need to hear it from sound more contemporary.
I keep on falling in and out of love with you.
Thank you. Like that. I say, I like you.
16. I was impressed.
I thought the first song was annoying.
Yeah, but...
Really annoying. Verging on fingers going down a blackboard.
No, yeah. It wasn't that bad. Kyle, yeah, come on. Come on.
Two bars of falling, you could tell she can sing.
Yeah, come on.
I'm going to say no.
I'm going to say...
You know what, Paula? I don't know what's going on with his ears today. What do you think is happening with
him? No, it's a little weird.
He's weird today.
A little weird.
Randy, yes or no?
I'm obviously going to say yes, because I'm thinking like, well, this girl can sing. She's got a great voice. She's 60. Dude.
One no, one yes. Paula.
I say right on, yes.
Welcome to Hollywood!
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Dad's rock star. His daughter about to be one, too.
Okay, wait a minute. What's going on with you today, Doc?
Not for me.
You got a cold?
Not for me.
Did you sleep well?
I slept very well.
What was wrong with her?
Not my thing.
Simon's a little crazy today, San Francisco.
Coming up, can things get any rockier in the audition room?
Paula, that was rude.
By season 5 of American Idol, you'd think we'd seen and heard it all. Of course, there have been a lot of singers. And dancers.
Whoa.
Some rappers.
Stop what you're doing, cause I'm about to ruin every single style that you used to.
And plenty of beatboxers. But never have we had the quadruple threat. Meet the master of all terrains, Marcus Phillips.
What's up with the Bay Area? It's the Bay Area affiliate in the Kid Chaos, a.k.a. Marcus Phillips. You know what I'm saying? We out here in the building. San Francisco, Bay Area!
How old are you, Marcus?
Me, I'm 23 years old.
23 years old, and you say it, you're an all-terrain entertainer.
Yes, I'm an ATE, all-terrain entertainer. Singer, rapper, songwriter, dancer, comedian, actor. You know what I'm saying? I want to do the big screen right now. I'm touching one of my accomplishments. I'm doing a little screen. You know what I'm saying?
Let's see all your terrain.
All right. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Oh, you know that this little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, I'm gonna let it shine. Oh, yeah.
Thank you.
Well, I wanna hear you rap.
Yeah, do your thing.
You want me to do a rap?
All terrain, baby,
all
do
terrain,
it.
All terrain, the whole thing.
But that's just one thing that you must understand. I said, I'm not that guy that's trying to be your man. I just want to be the fantastic, anonymous, near that you can call my number one fan.
Wow.
Anyway. Oh, you're dancing now? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Beatbox. I gotta tell you, you are the all-terrain entertainer.
I do what I can, pretty lady. I do what I can.
Here's the problem. The singing is like you all go into the falsetto.
That's what I do, man. It's just me. You know what I'm saying? You gotta let it shine. Got to, family.
I gotta say no, dog. Singing is not on point. Not on point.
It's not.
Well, hey, I do what I can. Have a nice one.
All right, good looking out, man.
It doesn't matter. I'm gonna be out there one way or another. You'll see me again, America. It's all right. I'm really not tripping too hard.
So it looks like the all-terrain entertainer is going to be all right. Next into the room is college student Jane Santayana.
How are you?
I'm excited. Great.
All right, so what are you gonna sing?
Sweet Love by Anita Baker.
All right.
Go for it.
I'm in love, sweet love. Hear me calling out your name. I feel no shame. I'm in love, sweet love. Don't you ever and I'll always be this way.
Oh. Paula Abdul, what do you think?
I think you're pretty awesome.
Oh, thanks.
For me, I think the song was way, 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 way too big for you.
Oh, really?
Yeah. And you didn't conquer the song.
You're saying, oh, really, because you don't believe what he's saying.
No.
Of course. Trust me, the world hears through different ears.
Exactly.
Right?
That's true.
Simon's having an off day today, Paula. I don't know. What's going on with you, man? Come on. Come on, Simon, dude, this is weird. You have an off day, San Francisco.
I'm being honest. I just thought the song was too big for the girl.
Okay, maybe wrong song. What do you think about her?
Yeah, what about her voice?
No, it's a no.
Oh my God. This, you know what?
Wow. Honestly, I'm surprised.
Not for me.
I'm shocked. We're shocked. You're shocked.
I'm shocked. Too.
It's all right. Beethoven and Mozart are going to put you through.
Oh, come on.
Wow.
Is this Ebenezer Scrooge over here that's like, but what's going on with
Beethoven,
his ears today?
Beethoven, yes or no?
100% yes. Another one of the better voices I've heard today. Yes, yes.
And Mozart says yes, too.
Welcome to Hollywood. Oh, my God.
Hey, I will prove you wrong,
good,
Simon.
Good.
Under my belt.
Great.
So
good. Great.
I'll do it for you. So.
Great.
See you in Hollywood, dear.
Thank you so much, guys. I love you.
God, what?
I love it. You're saying no to
everybody.
Dude,
who are you listening to today?
Didn't get it.
Is there a different radio playing in your head?
Didn't
What's happening?
Didn't get it.
You didn't get that?
Nope.
I know. Whatever.
Wow.
So Jane sparked some tension amongst the panel. But little did she know, she had just ignited a firestorm in the judging room. In one corner, Paula Abdul and Randy Jackson. And in the other corner, Simon Cowell.
Simon's having a tough day today.
No, I'm not.
You are.
No, I'm not.
It's when we kiss, oh, fire.
I don't think you have any voice at all. I think it's just terrible.
No, she can sing. It wasn't.
Randy.
No, she can sing. It just wasn't pleasant.
But I got to make sure that you'll always be around.
I thought you were terrific. Excellent.
Thank you.
Really?
Yeah.
I thought she was excellent?
Yep.
I thought she was pretty good, but I didn't think she was excellent.
Wow. Well, surprise, surprise.
Oh.
Let's give up something to talk about.
All right, so yes or no, Simon?
Never.
Why?
Are you winding me up?
No, why? What do you mean? Why?
One of the worst voices I've ever heard.
Oh, anyway. Anyway.
Not true.
True.
Not true.
True.
Wasn't as bad as he says at all.
It was, Kelly, yeah. And I like you, but it was that bad.
Her name's Sherry.
Sherry.
Sherry. What do you even know her name? Kelly, Barbara, whatever.
When we come back, the seeds have been sown. But what finally sends Simon over the edge? Welcome back to American Idol here in San Francisco. It is pretty late in the day, and so far it's been a rough one. The judges are fighting, Simon's in a foul mood. Basically, everyone is a bit on edge. It's a good thing there are only a few more contestants to see.
I'm Deborah Dawn Tilley. I'm from Ely, Nevada, and I'm 27. I'm the rock girl. People recognize me by my hair. Hey, Lady Big Hair.
You've been in a band since you were 7
yes,
years old.
Yes, different bands.
So you should be able to ace this audition.
I hope so.
Right?
I hope so.
All rock?
The rock girl.
All rock.
Why didn't you ask me, baby? Didn't you think I could? Well, Blue is out of sight and the shillelagh's paying tonight. Why couldn't it be you, me, baby? I'll show you how to do it right. Do it right. Do it right. Do it right. Twist it. She, baby.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Paula.
Oh, Deborah Dawn. Little bit much, but you're interesting. Very interesting.
Paula, yes or no?
Yes. Got a great voice.
Randy.
Vocally, I wasn't like, you know, you got the whole gravelly, all the attitude, but I wasn't, the voice didn't really like blow me away.
You know, the problem is that you can sing, but you're kind of like somebody's mother who for a dare has been told to look like Cher for some ghastly fancy dress party and does a song. That's how the whole thing came over.
I'm gonna say no. It's just okay for me. Just okay. It's up to Simon Cowell. Look at that man's face.
I know it sounds rude, but I almost need to hear you singing with my eyes shut. Because I'm so put off by this image.
Isn't that what you said about Clay Aiken?
Ooh.
Were you there?
When you said it, yeah.
You weren't there the first time we met him. You didn't put him through.
I wasn't there, but I heard you say it to him.
But you weren't there, so how can you say that?
Anyway, she's here.
You said it in front of me.
But you weren't there, so how can
you
I say that?
You said it during the live shows.
What about Miss Dawn? Delta Dawn, I mean, Deborah Dawn.
No.
Sorry, Deborah. Is it Deborah?
Yeah.
Sorry. Deborah, you're talented.
Thank you guys for this opportunity.
Thank you.
Keep on rocking.
I wouldn't have known if you said it if I didn't hear you say it live television. I hit you when you said it on the live show.
Simon's having a bad day.
Oh,
let's
and
get
I'm
this
not.
Over. Let's get this over. Come on.
And I'm not. You know what? You can do this on your own for a while.
Oh. What's that about?
What's wrong with him today?
It's a good act.
Oh, San Francisco. Let's just get through it.
So it's the end of the day, and apparently Simon has just decided to storm off. I don't know the exact reason as to why, but Randy and Paula have been going after him all day long, and he just said, I'm tired of it. I'm leaving.
And it wasn't an act. He was dead serious and went straight back to his hotel. Back inside, there's still one more contestant to see, and Randy and Paula hoped San Francisco saved the best for last.
Oh, yeah.
I've seen honey, I've seen tea, but I've never seen a singer doing shots of hot sauce before they get in to perform.
My name is Manuel Viramontes. What America's gonna love about my voice, it's pure, it's honest. I'm that hard worker that's gonna go that extra mile, that's gonna go that extra distance.
What are you holding?
I'm holding a religious statue, actually. It's El Santo Niño de Atocha. It's my favorite saint. My mother, she couldn't have babies for the longest time, and she prayed and prayed to the saint. And she promised that if she would have the baby, that she would name it after him. And that's how I got my name, Manuel. So I promised my saint that if he would grant me my wish of making my dreams come true just one day, that I would never, ever ask for anything ever again, and I would...
Nice story. Nice, very nice. Good. You're here because you are the best undiscovered talent?
I think so, yeah.
What are you going to sing to prove it?
Ribbon in the Sky by Stevie Wonder.
Big song. Come on, do it proud, baby.
All right, thank you. If I can have a moment, thank you. And oh, so long, and for this night I prayed, and that a star would guide you my way. There's a ribbon in the sky for our love. There's a ribbon in the sky. I said there's a ribbon in the sky. For our love.
Wow.
I feel like we've landed on another planet in San Francisco, Paula. What's going on, dude? Dude, what was the voice? What was the thing
you
with it?
You are the sunshine of my life.
Oh, no, 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 Manuel.
Forever you'll stay
Manuel.
In my heart.
Manuel, no, 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 Manuel. It's okay, baby. It's all good, man. It wasn't good the first time. It's not good the second time.
Mama.
Oh, dude. Come on.
I don't want to die, but if I'm not back again, this time tomorrow.
Stop. Time out. Time out. Manuel.
Yes, sir.
Yes or no, Paula?
I'm sorry, sweetheart. No.
Dude, whoa.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, honey.
And
And despite the day having more twists and turns than Lombard Street, 18 people are headed to Hollywood.
Welcome to Hollywood, baby!
Proving they were just what the judges needed. So that is it from San Francisco, and as you've just seen, the day dramatically ends without Simon Cowell. Not exactly a team player today. But will he get over it in time for our next stop? Join us next week as Idol hits Vegas. Cowell does come back, but he's not happy.
You're actually giving me a headache.
Who would have predicted that psychic Bobby May would be back?
I could sing if you want.
No, you don't have to.
However, he does let some people sing.
This is your audition now.
I'm far from my folks back home.
But there's stuff like this that will drive you out of your mind.
Oops.
You'd be crazy to miss it. See you next time.
Hooray!